show now, and in just a moment we'll begin our broadcast. There are some things I would have to warn you about. The following program contains obscene and profane language and situations which may be upsetting to sensitive individuals who are unwilling to indulge in most forms of humor and satire. The special gong created for tonight's show by Mark Pauline of Survival Research Laboratories may damage the hearing of some super sensitive individuals or cause pregnant women to give birth to monsters of genetic abnormality. Parental repression is advised. And now, from the fabulous Crucible Steel Gallery, you asked for it, the show which is a rehash and a retread of all your nightmarish memories of television shows past and future, brings you The Gong Show. Let's give a You Asked For It welcome to Sebastion Melmouth. He burned too brightly for Burning Man. He was ejected from the Cacophony Society for being too cacophonous. A salacious, seditious Santa Claus, a survivor of the San Francisco Suicide Club after 37 attempts, an all-round malevolent malfeasor, he takes his place now as a bonger of the deadly gong. Our first judge, the immoral Sebastion Melmouth. Lisa Leathertongue peddles smut-laden videos from her lair at Leathertongue Video. She's here, she's queer, and she's someone to fear, the one and only Lisa Leathertongue. Mark Pauline is known as the man with the biggest heart in San Francisco. Science is eternally grateful for his timely discovery of obtainium, the 200th element, which he now sends grateful urchins all over the city to collect for his survival research laboratory. So, above the kids, welcome Mark Pauline. And now I have the great honor to introduce the man of the hour, tonight's host of the Gong Show. He's that loose-limbed loser extraordinaire, that circus Svengali, Chicken John!
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. Welcome to tonight's show. We have the Gong Show for you.
Just a second.
Get that bum out of there.
Oh, and thank you guys for coming out. We got a great show for you. We worked on it all day. All right, we have our celebrity judges in place. How are you doing tonight, Mr. Melmouth?
I'm doing fine, Chick. How about you?
Okay. We're looking at a lot of people. It's going to be a fun show.
Yeah, we're going to go.
Are you ready? Now, you are going to treat each and every act with, you know, and even, you know, sensitivity and, you know, and understand that this is, you know, their feelings are at stake here.
No, it'll be completely subjective on our part.
Subjective, good word. Lisa Leathertongue, thank you very much for sponsoring our show for the last 5 months. Lisa Leathertongue. You sponsored my show here. You believed in us here and the work that we were doing here in the game show field. And you've sponsored us. You've given us free video rentals, a total of 250 free video rentals for our...
I can cut in for Lisa here. Her store provides only family entertainment. So if you're interested in family entertainment.
Family entertainment, ladies and gentlemen, and brotherly love. That's right.
That's right. My family loves it.
Mr. Mark Pauline, thank you very much for making this gong for our lovely show tonight.
I didn't make it. I picked it up cheap.
That is a piece of obtainium there, isn't it, Mark?
Yes.
Obtainium, you're all familiar with the precious metal, obtainium.
Every part on that machine.
Obtainium, the 200th element, the one that that Mark discovered some years ago.
Okay, then, are you ready to start our show? I can't hear you. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, the first item up for bids we have is a trained professional, I guarantee it. Or half your money back in 4 to 6 weeks. Reverend Hal, tell them all about it.
Now, ukulele fans, say aloha to the incomparable David Jesse.
How about an A for that? An A, ladies and gentlemen. We got some high marks going here. Lisa, let her tell me what you think.
I was hoping she had the person an A. And then I would have thought it was going to be harder. She could have cut herself.
Disappointed with the lack of vampire fangs. You lose his points for that.
A 7.5.
A 7.5. And Mr. Mark Foley, what do you say?
5.
A 5. Stephanie, thank you very much for participating in our stupid show.
That's right, folks. You'd better pull in those limbs,
over here.
They might just be lopped off by our next act. Give them all the room they need. Here they come, the BMX Bike Troop.
Critical mind in the entire audience.
Okay. But how low will he go, ladies and gentlemen? Lower? Lower? Pauline, what did you think of the lowest man? The lowest man.
I think I have to give him the lowest score, negative 10.
What score do we give this guy?
I don't know if this is entirely fair because I still owe Bob some money, but
well, how much you owe him?
I'm gonna have to give him a nine.
Lisa Leathertown, what kind of score we got for the lowest man in show business?
Big point spread here, and
gung him for the hair.
They got nothing to do with football, and since no one's saying football acts yet, I gave it a 2.
Robert Burke, thank you very much for being the low guy. Ladies and gentlemen, we're going to stop the show for a brief moment. We're going to take a short break. We're going to do a small commercial with our announcer, the Dr. Reverend Howell and Owl.
Back in Granddad's day, it was important for a young man to practice good grooming, to be smart as a buggy whip, and in order to look sharp, feel sharp, be sharp, a young buck would often as not slick back his hair with a good brilliantine hair cream or glistening hair with not a hair out of place, that exciting Rudolph Vaselino look. Well, I don't have to tell you that times have changed. Today's postmodern now-a-go-go fashion follower usually doesn't slick back his crowning glory. He lets his locks flow free. But you know, there's still a need for good grooming. Where it counts. I'm talking about pubic hair, of course. How many relationships have crashed on the rocks of romance because of those pesky pubic hairs tangling and getting in the way? Well, here's where Grandpa's solution still comes in handy. Just a drop of clean, clear new Score hair cream on the crotch will slick back those annoying flyaway pubes so you can score again and again. So pick up Score today, and you'll hear them say, clearly, clearly he knows his score. New clear Score hair cream. And now, back to the Gong Show and Chicken John!
Ladies and gentlemen, the next item I have up for bids, tell them all about it, Hal.
Well, Chicken, you know, too much is always better than not enough. All right, everybody. The next performer asks for your silent attention as he hones his deadly skill with extreme concentration. Knife chucker, Don Paul.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. Could you please join us? My name is Don Paul, and I am a knife thrower.
Relax.
All right, folks, I'm a knife thrower. Now, being a knife thrower takes intense focus of mental and physical energies.
Being a knife thrower's assistant is more dangerous. Are you ready for this? Ladies and gentlemen,
put up or shut
I am
up
going
we're
to hurl. I am going to hurl these implements at the body of my beloved mate and companion. That's right, ladies and gentlemen.
Ladies and gentlemen, absolute silence, please.
Chicken. Rex, the roller skating rascal, will now, before your astonished peepers, attempt to roller skate through a flaming hoop of toxic fire while wearing a straight jacket. Let's take a look, a very close look, at Rex, the roller.
Rex, are you ready? I think Rex is ready. Ladies and gentlemen, are you ready?
You did pay off the fire marshal with your chicken.
What fire marshal? Ladies and gentlemen, here he comes.
Let's smell some air. Oh, God. Wait a minute.
the roller Rex act.
I mean, I've had my face burned off, but man, this was the hair that did it for me. I like to smell the hair. I give it a 0.999.
I gave this.
That's a secret, Lisa.
Well, since there weren't any bongos in the act or any hippie tribal drumming, I'm going to give Rex an 8.
An 8, ladies and gentlemen. An 8. Ladies and gentlemen, the Gong Show was on for 3 years. Started in 1976 and went to 1978 and a half, something like that. What's happened is the Gong Show, they didn't go away. They got canceled, ladies and gentlemen. The censors canceled the Gong Show. The band came down. The Gong Show, the man. You hear what I'm saying? Ladies and gentlemen, I am going to give you the act that got the Gong Show canceled. It was very. Ladies and gentlemen, I give you the Popsicle Twins. Here they are.
These two schoolgirls from Our Lady of Sorrows Middle School, well, they're fresh and frisky. And there's nothing they like more than these quiescently frozen confections.
What did they do, Chuck Barris?
Together for Mikl Em and Seth. Together, they go as Try This at Home.
The person here's got to know where the breaker is. No power. Because I can't do that with my finger anymore.
ain't going there, ladies and gentlemen. Sebastion Melmouth, what do you got for me here?
All right, well, all the stretching exercise and everything, I can't do anything even vaguely like that, so I'm going to have to give her a 9.
A 9, ladies and gentlemen. It's looking awful good. What could happen next?
Well, what can happen next, you'll soon find, as we welcome Woody Itzen and Martin Aparico, who will perform to the Miami Heat.
Thank you.
stopped and yelled out, "Whores! You guys are whores!" And my friend turned around, looked at him, and said, "That's right. That's the way we like it." Petty officer, as you say.
Arr. Now I'm the chief petty officer.
Anchors away. Bill Clinton is innocent. He is our commander-in-chief, and I advise all of you.
Jesus Christ.
You're gonna love this one, folks. It is my profound pleasure to introduce to you that sublime interpreter of Turks and Orient talent,
This reminds me of what I used to be like when I was younger. I think the audience is doing the work. It's got a lot of spirit. A lot of spirit.
Take it off, Todd.
Mark, is this you?
Go ahead, come on. If you strip down, everything, we'll let it go. Hey, audience, are you going to let him get away with this? Four.
This show. You guys are embarrassed to admit it. I understand. I would be embarrassed to admit that I kept coming back to Chicken John's game show. It's fucking... But this guy keeps coming back for more abuse and more punishment. But anyhow, here he is, ladies and gentlemen. San Francisco's premier monologuist, Mikl Pepe. Come on out.
This man alone.
What can you say about a legend? Words fail.
A monumental talent.
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen.
Okay, are we even yet, Mikl?
Thank you very much, ladies and gentlemen. You know, I just can't believe they put me after all those acts, like next to last. I can't believe it. It's a monologue next to last.
As if that wasn't totally predictable.
Bring back the ukulele guy, will you? Are we still
you guys want to see the ukulele guy one more time?
Ukulele guy, come on, let's see the ukulele guy.
Is he still here?
He's off.
We're here to give you another chance. Oh, we feel that because we put you on first, it was unfair that they were hungry for blood. Is it true? But are you going to be more fair and even-handed with them now?
Well, now we're going to hear his incomparable musical stylings. Ladies and gentlemen, once more, for your pleasure and entertainment, the one and only David Jesse.
Lowbrow and all about nothing and stuff. You guys are gonna love this one.
If they don't. don't care for the finer things in music and art, maybe they'll like the creators of the celebrated Siamese twin splosh, Daisy and Maisie, the Chaos Kittens.
Here they are, ladies and gentlemen. Trooper, ladies and gentlemen. 18.9999.
And I thought that was his golf handicap.
Roller Rex! On the count of three, I want each and every person here to say... One, two, three! I love that word. Okay, the guy who smashed the couch up. What the fuck is that? We have a negative one for the couch thing. Negative one. Sorry, guys. We have the, Lisa? Where's Lisa? Come on, step forward, Lisa. The Elastic Lass. Well, the stretch girl got 28, thank you. Seventh grade education, I'm up here, you're out there. I need you, I hire you, thank you. These guys are great. Okay, we got 10, 20, 29. We got 29 here. That's looking the best so far. And then the next act that actually got a score was the rope act. Sadie Masochista. Now, Sadie Masochista, I think that she was unfairly judged, ladies and gentlemen. So, right now, the two highest scores are 29 and 123. I don't feel that Sadie's act was properly judged. Now, hold on now. Wait a minute now. Give me a chance here. I gotta be fucking fair. Just for fun, ladies and gentlemen, if I were to ask you guys to pick, would it be the Hermanarachis right here?